Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever that he says, that is what he's going to do. That can query him. There is no one that can question him. There is no one that can challenge him. His power is above all other power. His name is above all other names.
Jesus Christ.
Dear brethren, I am telling you, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. He's the King of all kings. Jesus Christ.
Are you alright, Mike?
Yeah.
You alright?
Yeah, man.
How's it going?
Alright, we're not going half an hour. It goes to.
I know.
Enjoy.
How you doing, mate? You alright? Did you have a good time?
Yeah. Mad, isn't it?
Did you have a chat with Paul there?
Yeah, I did, yeah. Spoke to him.
Is it alright?
Yeah, we've got him. Just kept it clear.
Yeah? Did you have some good conversations today?
Hello?
You have some good conversations.
Oh, yeah, I've had some few arguments, good conversations as well.
Good.
Well, I've got to give the gospel, you know, the way the master, you know.
Good, bro. God bless you, mate.
Amen.
Well, this is Hyde Park, folks. What's it about, bro? What's it about? We're moving over there. Moving over here. Boy, there's loads of them today, isn't it, mate? Loads of them. Hallelujah. God is... Here's another one. Arguing there. They're all arguing. Oh, now there's some over here. Let's see who these are. God bless you. Assalamu alaikum. Has it been a good day? No, Christian.
Oh, okay.
Christian, but you're a nice person. Just thought I'd say hello.
Yeah, thank you.
So are you okay?
Yeah, but thank you.
Have you been coming here long?
Yeah.
Have you?
Yeah.
So you're an expert?
Sort of, not really.
Yeah? Oh. What advice would you give anybody coming down? Hey, Mansoor, how you doing?
Jason?
You okay? Yeah, nice to see you, bro.
You okay?
I've not come to debate, I'm just filming it. Are you okay? Are you alright?
How are you?
I'm okay, thanks, yeah. Gotta go soon. Are they organising the debate or something?
Yeah.
What, today or tomorrow?
I don't know if it's today or tomorrow. I'm not sure. Nothing yet. It hasn't started yet.
Just get in there. It's a busy all day. Mohammed, you know that.
Hello, Jason.
How you doing, bro? You alright?
Yeah,
good
right.
To see you, mate.
Alright. We get some new guys, like Jason, who's from Manchester. They come down.
From Manchester, oh. Yeah. Which team do you support?
Yeah, he's Christian.
It's good to see you.
We get many sisters.
I'm a red.
He's kind of a regular, but we get many.
all that detail.
My son's got cancer too.
I came on only 15 to go to
the
I was holding his copy and holding the Bible version.
Muhammad, you start.
I'm going to miss this set. I think he's my favorite.
Muhammad, he's alright.
No, because sometimes
I'm going to go. Because you realize, now that you're here, if you go look around, you'll see how they come across the world first. So you have to be like that.
Fight. Don't fight with Zamzam.
Yeah.
Fight with fire.
Yeah. Is
this what's up?
I can't hear it. But it's noisy, innit? Hey, bye, yeah. So, if I had a... Oh, my.
Also, Fatima was saying that it relates to Islam. I just want us to have that conversation. So, Fatima, do you want to summarize your claim, basically, that you made last
week? Yeah, it's not my claim, actually. Just looking at the media and seeing... Looking at media and seeing what they are giving us information regarding what's happening in Ukraine. From Oxford to Leicester, from Loughborough to Slough, also part of the world, approximately over 40 places, and on the end of 2015, 177 people have been convicted as who took part in Ukraine. And it came on to this as this is Pakistan, Asian community issue, especially the Pakistani issue. But when you look at the people who've been kind of convicted, 177 names, you see most of those names are Muslim names, and most of those people go to the church, go to the mosque, celebrate the Eid. They encourage those girls who are from age 11 to 16 to read the Quran. So I guess I am saying because Islam is giving very low view of women, and in one sense Surah 24:23 is supporting slave girls to can put into the prostitution, I'm saying actually it is not Pakistan Asian community issue. In somehow it's a Muslim issue.
Okay. So the claim is that it's a Muslim issue. We've got statistics. What I looked at the Child Online Protection Service, and they said that when it comes to Asian grooming, it accounts for about 28% of all cases. And in fact, they said 415 people from 2008 until 2012 were involved in grooming. That's 415. Of them, of the 415, according to the Child Online Protection Service, 40 were either Pakistani or Bangladeshi. That is to say, from 415, 40, which is 10% or less than 10%, were Muslim. So when we say Asian grooming gangs, we should be very specific, because actually the majority of Asians, according to the Child Online Protection Service survey, and that is the most reliable data that almost all the outlets.
We're going to pause for a moment because I started out sharing my story. Sorry? No, you're still there. So, you know, I didn't even have to preach against Islam to show Islam.
No.
They're preaching themselves.
Amen.
They're not doing anything.
Well, why are you... No, let me ask you something. Can I ask you something? Can I ask you something?
I'll wait for you. I'll
wait for me then.
Yes.
Because, you know... No, I'm not giving you a time.
He's asking you.
Are you listening to me?
Okay, yes.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
He's going to ask you.
Will you answer my question?
Listen to me.
I'll wait.
Just listen to him.
Ask anyone.
I don't even want to talk.
Let this brother speak. Just be quiet. Be quiet. Be quiet. Be quiet and let him speak.
Listen. When you were in grade one.
Sorry?
When you were in grade one. Assuming you went to grade one.
I think so. I did.
When somebody is asking a question.
Okay, guys.
When someone's asking a question.
Because
what is it?
I don't want people to think, as he's claiming that we are a bunch of barbarians. We want a civilized discussion. We want a civilized discussion.
He did not say that. When did he say that? He did not say that.
He's claiming that we are aggressive, we are hijacking. He can preach as long as he wants. We cannot stop him. This is Britain. This is London. He's free to talk. I am asking whether
we got a hijacker
to ask questions.
I'm not promising you anything.
All I want is civilized discussion.
I want to share my message.
Fine.
You hijacked me. Do you admit you hijacked me?
Keep saying
do you admit it? Am I in a conversation with you? I'm trying to preach.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
I don't want to be one. I don't know you.
Answer my question.
I'm preaching my story. And you hijacked me. Is it right what you did?
No. This is
okay. Then repent.
Are you new here? Are you new in London?
Repent.
Are you new?
Repent.
Are you new in London?
Okay. We got a man that doesn't want to repent. I can't deal with you.
God bless you.
Block this guy out. Block this guy out. Block him up.
Everyone can see what's happening.
You're blocking. Go away. Go away, sir. Go away. Go on, bro.
You see, eight preachers.
I came here.
Go away, sir. Go away.
A bunch of hate preachers who come to London to pollute the world.
He is a mighty man of God.
Of course they are afraid.
He is a mighty man of God.
Of course they are afraid.
A mighty man of God. God bless you.
So what is he afraid of? Let the guy speak in it and then you can question.
He's afraid to answer
it. Let him speak.
Are you Christian?
You've got to stop.
You want to answer my question?
You've got to stop being
aggressive.
You've got to stop. You've got to stop being aggressive.
Right.
Stop being aggressive.
In a civilized manner.
Stop being aggressive. Stop being aggressive.
Why are you still talking to me? Don't be aggressive, just chill out. Where's the aggressive?
Just chill out. Calm down and chill out, guys.
What about you?
Guys, chill out.
What about you?
Chill out.
You didn't need to chill yourself.
Chill out. Chill out.
You didn't need to chill yourself.
Treat with women with respect, bro. Chill out.
With no one to the women.
God bless you.
For yourself. Which one, by the way? Which one? Which one?
God bless you.
Just to clarify. Which one?
Nice to meet you, sir. Nice to meet you. God bless you.
I didn't read the Quran at the time. I didn't know anything about Islam. Okay?
It wasn't until my friend, who was a Muslim, started introducing me to Islam. So I started reading the Quran. Like I said before, as I started reading, I saw many wonderful things in it. I saw that it taught you to believe in God and the prophets and live a holy life and live in repentance. I have no problems with that. No problems whatsoever. And what I was sharing before is that I agree a lot with my Islamic friend's standard of dress. Not everything. Okay, I don't think a woman has to always cover their face and everything, but I do agree with the idea of modesty and the values. It's very high, and I respect it. In fact, and you can hate me as a Christian, I don't care. I'm not here to be your best friend. When I saw a Muslim girl walk in my high school, something struck out at me, and I was like, wow, that's how a holy woman should dress. It was honorable to me. So I need to say something to my Muslim friends here, and I say friends, not because I agree with your religion. So you need to know the difference. If you see me on YouTube and I challenge people's philosophy and way of life. But I don't want you to mistake the fact that I'm a human being just like you. And on a human-to-human level, I have no problem with you. If you're a homosexual, I would bring you to my house. If you try to teach my kids about homosexuality, you're out of my house. No offense. If you're a Muslim, you're welcome to my house. But if you try to force and hijack my house, like that guy tried to hijack my conversation, you're out. He hijacked my conversation. Okay, but anyway, listen. If you don't like the word,
I like what you're saying. That's
fine. Can I just get that?
Yeah, go.
Listen, man, I'm a guy from the streets. If you can't handle words from the streets, that's up to you. You want to be politically correct? I'm not from England. You know what I notice about y'all people in England? You guys are a bunch of politically correct people. And it's so fake and phony, it's disgusting. It's disgusting. Islam is not the same thing as Christianity. Neither is Judaism the same. Listen, they're different. Let's be honest. Stop with this lies and saying, well, we believe the same thing. No, you don't. You do not believe the same Jesus as Christians. No, you don't. It's a different Jesus. Let's face it. One Jesus died on the cross, the other didn't. So it's better to be honest so that we can actually deal with the problem. But nonetheless, the fact of the matter is, I started reading, I saw good things. I remember when I was in high school, the first time I ever preached a message, I was telling people they need to repent of sin. I never knew John 3:16. I never knew. All I knew is whoever confesses the name of the Lord must depart from iniquity. That was my message. I was like a John the Baptist from my community. And I needed that. And so I told everybody, repent. Turn from your sin. Turn to God. Have faith in God. This is what I preach.
When the question time comes, please let me know because I have
questions. I'm not talking to you. I'll talk to someone more qualified. I'm not talking. So anyway, listen. So I told everybody to repent. I told everybody to repent. And the reason why I won't talk to him is because I've dealt with many infidels in the past. And I'm going to tell you something.
These are Islamic arguing in Canada who have come
to London. Be quiet, infidel. Infidel, be quiet.
That's so far the only hateful like person right now.
He's a well-known Islamophobe. He's a hate preacher. He's a well-known hate preacher.
You're spewing out hate. You're spewing out hate. You're spewing out hate.
That's why he doesn't want to talk.
You're spewing out hate.
That's why he's unable
I'm
not allowed to share my story.
Go on, bro.
Because you know what? You know what I don't believe in? You know, I walked around when I first came here. I walked around. I respectfully listened to every individual. I didn't interrupt and barge my way. You know why? Because the Bible says, love is not rude. I know the God of love. Love is not rude.
Amen.
I don't need to sit and debate there to get my face on the internet or anything. People come to me. You know why? Because what I'm saying is convicting and shakes the heart.
Yes. Amen, bro.
My story is real. People want to hear from what I got to say. Not because I'm special, but because the God of the universe is in my life. So listen to me. So when I started to read the Quran, and when I started to do what I had to do,
I'm from Manchester.
I started to see some differences. Okay? And the differences were very subtle. I preached my first message in high school to Muslims, Christians, and everybody that was there, Hindus. And I told everybody what Jesus did for me. And there was a Muslim way in the back. He said, well, what about Muhammad? Because I was saying Jesus is the only way. And I said, who's Muhammad?
He got the hate
Who's
preach.
That? And so, this became my first public debate. My first public debate was in high school, where I didn't know anything about really the Quran that well. So he was talking to me and about Muhammad, he's a final prophet. And I said, well, I don't know about that stuff, but I know that Jesus died for me. And he said, well, you know, Muhammad's a final prophet, you need to read the Quran. And I'm like, What's that, man? Like, I don't know where that comes from, man. I have the Bible. And so we were just young people, 16 years old, talking about the Bible, about Islam and Quran. And this was where everything began for me. I started to learn that Muslims want everybody to become Muslim. Sure. But I also knew that Christians want everybody to become Christians.
And atheists
That's fair.
Want
to be atheists. And atheists want everybody to be atheists. Okay? Fair is fair. I had no problems with that. Okay? Whatever people want to do. So I was asking my friend, you know, what does somebody have to do to become a Muslim? And he says, well, you need to believe in one God and that Muhammad's the final prophet. That started to make me think, why is Muhammad the final prophet? Like, what about Jesus? And then they said, well, God gave him the final revelation to clear up all the things that were unclear in the past and to give people a good path to live. And I said, okay, so tell me more about Muhammad. Well, he grew up in Arabia, and he got a message saying to recite, and that was the story. I'm like, okay. So then the crux of the matter came, and he used to tell me, well, listen, man, we believe in the same God, just become a Muslim. And I said, well, I already have salvation, so why do I need Muhammad? And he said, no, Jesus never died on the cross.
Sorry. Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord.
He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord.
Every tongue shall bow. Every tongue confess. Jesus Christ is Lord.
He is Lord.
Every tree shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah, folks! Lord is Lord. He is Lord.
Praise God!
Of the day, He is Lord. Every tongue shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead. For He is Lord. Every tongue shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Christ is Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What you doing here?
Hallelujah.
Are you preaching or something?
Jesus. Worshiping Jesus. Worshiping the Lord. Worshiping Jesus.
They understand what
Hey, yes, Lord. Come and sing. Come on. Come and sing. Come and sing. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead. He is Lord. Hallelujah! Great song shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
God,
He is Lord. He has risen from the dead, for He is Lord. He will be shall bow every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Risen from the dead, for He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess